For more than a decade, the journey of Godsmack has taken us from some of the smallest clubs in Boston to some of the largest stages across the world. Through 4 records and thousands of gigs, we have crushed audiences all over the world doing what we do best.
Rock and f***ing roll.
And then it was silence. For 2 years, we've been resting, we've been writing, we are fully reloaded.
And now, we're back!
Strap yourself in and join us for the making of Saints and Sinners, Godsmack 5.
I'll tell you this so far about this record, which I've really been enjoying, is that on this album cycle, we decided to do this a completely different way than we used to do it. You know, rock bands normally, and our habit in the past has been record the drums, that takes about a week or two, then you record all the bass lines, and then the guitars, and then the layers, and then you sing. And it's a bummer, you know, because then the drummer's around for a couple of weeks and then he's gone. He doesn't get to see the rest of the creative process happen. Same thing with the bass, he finishes his bits and splits. And by the end, it's usually me by myself doing vocals, mixing, and all that stuff.
So we wanted to keep it more homey and keep it together, so we decided to try to do a song a day. So we're here through the whole process.
This time we decided to go one song at a time. Drum track, play live, get the bass, the guitars, the vocals all done. So within a day or two, you kind of get a little bit of a reward and hear what the song sounds like.
Drums, percussion, bass, guitar, I guess which would ultimately be like left, right, basic frames. This would be an overdub, that's your leads. This is VH1, the TV channel, if we've watched it during the tracking or not. That's Van Halen. If it sounds like Van Halen, check it off. Just kidding, no, it's vocals, and that would be vocal harmonies. This is stuff that we're doing has effects on it. Typically programming, I guess is what you call it, and Vig's in there working on some of that stuff.
Viggy came on board with us during the Faceless record, and Viggy's just one of those guys that, you know, he's a true hard rock guy, loves the band. We became really good friends over the years.
I love everybody and everything.
I've known these guys for years and did their Faceless record and toured with them. We just recently done a crew fest together.
We brought him in to work with us, so if there's any kind of special effects or sound effects that we wanted on the record, we kind of gave him the ideas and he'd go, you know, create them or whatever. It's good to have someone like that around because he's in the other room, you know, dialing that stuff up and looking for ideas that I've voiced to him while we're in there getting, you know, the meat and potatoes of the song done.
All right, just touch this one.
Incoming.
One.
Coming in hot? Uh-huh. Come on, dude.
I turned fucking 40.
Weird.
And I every day I eat chocolate cake and fucking cheesecake. And
I'm a professional dessert eater.
When you get to be in your 40s, it's all about the cookies.
It's not gonna,
I heard in the 50s, it's about soup. And then in the 60s, it's about chips. Man, I can't eat enough of those things. And whenever I feel like I'm lacking intelligence or creativity, I'll pound down about 6 to 8 cookies with a cup of decaf. Boom. Just magic happened.
The whole thing. That's me working both amps.
See what I'm saying? It's just the texture to it. It's the chocolate and the coffee mixture. It's a Chips Ahoy festival, and I got Dave eating cookies like you wouldn't believe, and he's bitching about his weight, but yet he keeps bailing the cookies in.
I'm trying to bring chocolate into the vegetable world. How many calories can be in that? Fuck. A couple of hundred per cookie.
35 each.
That's it? Give me 3.
The last one.
I'm in, dude. Coming in hot. Oh, I like it. I like this forceful diet thing. Right there.
Mm.
Can we get meatballs?
Want to do it today?
I want
it
now.
I'm a night guy, and it turns out that Robbie and Sully are midday guys. So what we ended up doing is we found our vibe with having me do the drum track at night, so that the end of the day now is a drum track done.
That's so weird looking.
That's fucked up. It's like a fucking creature, like a weird insect or something.
It's so weird looking, but it's so cool sounding.
I'm concerned about your stage.
I'm gonna leave him here, though.
Look, Chips Ahoy, here's what it's gonna look like, right here. I'd like to thank everybody on the crew and everybody. This is our new song. You're cut off, bro. None. Except for me, I gotta know it.
That's cool. It's
pretty badass, dude.
It sounds awesome, and it looks even cooler. Because you look like a praying mantis.
You can't follow the Black Album with a fat gut on stage, dude. It doesn't happen. There's something on the side. Who's your friend? What's his name?
That's
who's your
Chip,
buddy?
Chip.
Chip?
This is Ahoy.
I can keep talking about food instead of rock and roll.
It's been the most group effort we've ever had as a band, for real. Like, every song has a little bit of all four of us in it.
Tony's an early bird, so he's in here at 10:30 in the morning. It takes him an hour or two to get his tracks done, then I come in, and then depending on how Sully's vocals are, he comes in the late afternoon, does all the vocals, and we have that in a can. Then later on, we have to go back, do leads and some overdubs, and then that night, what we do is we get Shannon back on the kit.
This is for all the cookies right here, Foreman.
Let's do it! Get a wrap! Oh, goddamn, Master! Oh, goddamn, Master!
For all the cookies!
Yeah.
All the cookies!
Here we go!
This is Shannon rocking What If.
And I felt killer.
There was a time we used to do shots of Crown Royal. Now I'm doing grass juice.